गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, येस्टरडे वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द टॉपिक मीटर ब्रिज एंड आई होप यू रिमेंबर व्हाट इज मीटर ब्रिज। स्टूडेंट्स, मीटर ब्रिज इज अ डिवाइस व्हिच इज यूज्ड टू मेजर अननोन रेजिस्टेंस। ओके, इट इज प्रैक्टिकल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ व्हीटस्टोन ब्रिज इन व्हिच देयर आर फोर रेजिस्टेंसेस connected in four arms of a rectangle and a cell and a galvanometer are connected in two diagonals of rectangle. So I hope you revised that topic. That topic is very important topic for your examination and for the practical purposes. Students, there is another very important topic of your chapter, and this one is also related to the experiment. Students, potentiometer is very important topic for experiment because there are two experiment based on the potentiometer, so you should study this topic very carefully. So first let us understand what is actually the potentiometer. So you can see this is a circuit and this one is another circuit. Okay, these two circuits, this complete circuit is not actually potentiometer, but the part this part is potentiometer. So let's understand what is potentiometer. First I am going to define potentiometer on the basis of their working. So student, potentiometer is a device which is used to measure the potential difference in any part of the circuit accurately. Okay, now you can ask, there is a voltmeter. Voltmeter is also a device which is used to measure potential difference between any two part of the circuit or between any two points of the circuit. But a student, potentiometer is more sensitive device. Its reading will be more accurate than voltmeter. So this one is better than voltmeter. Okay, so you can see here, this is a versatile instrument. It is basically a long piece of uniform wire, sometimes a few meters in length, across which a standard cell is connected. In actual design, the wire is sometimes cut in several pieces, placed side by side and connected at the ends by thick metal strip. In the figure, the wires run from A to C and the small vertical portions are the thick metal strips connecting the various sections of the wire. So in general, if I am going to draw the structure of potentiometer, actually this one is a cell and now this one is wire. Okay, now this one is a board, wooden board. Okay, this one is a wooden board and there are 1 meter long wire. It can be more than 3, 4, 5 according to the requirement. Okay, so now this one is the cell. These two points can be connected. This one is connected with a metal strip here. This one is a metal strip and at this point there is a screw. You can connect this wire to this screw. Okay, now you can see these wires are not connected to each other. So these wires are connected on the wooden board by thick metal strip to minimize the resistance of this part. So now you can see this wire has length 2 meter, 1 meter then 2 meter, okay. Now again these two are connected with thick metal strip to minimize the resistance. Now this wire has the length of 3 meter, okay. Again this one is connected to thick metal strip. Now suppose there is another wire, so you can connect these two together with thick metal strip, okay. So now you can see these boundary shows the wooden board and these are the wires 1 2 3 4 5. It means the total length of wire is 5 meter, 1 meter then 2 meter. We cannot take this part in consideration because it is thick metal strip and its resistance is taken as 0. This metal strip is only used for connecting these two wire, okay. So you can see here this length of this wire is 1 meter then 2 meter then 3 meter then 4 meter and the last is 5 meter, okay. So at this point there is a screw. You can connect this point, like this, okay. So this arrangement is known as a potentiometer. You can see there is a cell and the two terminals, the positive and negative terminals of the cell are connected at the two ends of a 5 meter long wire in this arrangement, okay. This one is 5 meter long wire, okay. In meter bridge there is only one wire 1 meter, so that apparatus is known as meter bridge. But in potentiometer the structure is very similar, but you can see the length of the wire is taken as very large. You can take 6 meter, 7 meter, 10 meter. It depends on the requirement, okay. So this one is the structure. Now you can read the structure. This is a versatile instrument. It is basically a long piece of uniform wire, sometimes a few meter in length, across which a standard cell is connected. In actual design, the wire is sometimes cut in several pieces and placed side by side and connected at the ends by thick metal strip. In figure, the wire run from A to C. So in this diagram, you can see this wire run from A to C by this. The same thing is shown here. This one is point A. You can write here A. And this one is point C. Okay. So the similar structure is shown here. These wires are clamped on a wooden board. So when current starts flowing through these wires, you can see here, if circuit is complete, there is current flowing through these wires. And it will follow this path like this, okay. So in that case, a current I flow through the wire, which can be varied by the variable rheostat R in the circuit. Since the wire is uniform, the potential difference between A and any point at distance L from A is given by this formula. So you can say that if I is current flowing through this, then V is equal to I into R, okay. Now this R is the total resistance of this 5 meter long wire, okay. If the wire has uniform cross section and equal length, then each wire has equal resistance, okay. So all the wires are connected in series. You can see here it means you can write the potential difference in each 1 meter length is same. Okay, potential difference in each 1 meter is same. So you can say that the potential difference per unit length is constant. Okay, and this is the basic principle of the potentiometer. This K is known as the potential gradient. Okay, so V is equal to K into L. The same thing is written here. E is at the place of V, phi is at place of K, and L is place of L. So you can write like this, where phi is known as the potential gradient, or you can say potential drop per unit length. Potential drop per unit length is known as potential gradient. So this is the basic principle of working of the potentiometer. Okay, now figure 3.28a shows an application of the potentiometer to compare the EMF of the two cells. So students, I hope you understand what is potentiometer. So potentiometer is a device which is used to measure the potential difference between any two points of a given circuit. Okay, then what is difference between potentiometer and voltmeter? Because we know that the voltmeter is also device which is used to measure potential difference between any two point of a given circuit. So student, voltmeter is also a device, but potentiometer gives very accurate reading as compared to voltmeter. It means it is better. This gives very accurate reading, very close to exact value of the potential difference, whereas voltmeter's reading is quite different than the actual reading. So this is the basic difference between potentiometer and voltmeter. Okay, now the working principle of the potentiometer is the potential drop per unit length of the potentiometer is always constant. It means its working is based on the potential gradient. Okay, now there are two uses of potentiometer which are part of your syllabus. So first one is comparison of EMF of two cells. You can see here two cell E1 and E2, and we want to compare their EMFs. Comparison means we want to find out the value of E1 by E2. Okay, so we want to compare these EMF of two cells. And then second application is finding the internal resistance of a given cell. So you can see here a cell. This one is a cell, and our aim is to find out internal resistance of this cell. So these are two applications of potentiometer which are part of your syllabus. Students, these two are experiment also. So this one is your fourth experiment, that is to compare the EMF of two primary cells by using potentiometer. And then your fifth experiment is to find the internal resistance of a given cell by using potentiometer. Okay, so because these two are experiments also, and these are the part of your syllabus, so this topic is very, very important. Okay, so let's understand how we can compare EMF of the two cells by using this potentiometer. Okay, so the circuit arrangement for this purpose is shown in this figure. You can see here. So let me explain the things given in this circuit. So in this circuit you can see this is the battery, this one is B, so this one is the battery and this one is a rheostat. Rheostat is a device by which you can control the current flowing through this circuit. Okay, now this one is a key. Key is used to open or close the circuit. You can see here from this point there are wires. This one is one wire, then second wire, then third wire, then fourth wire, then fifth wire, then sixth wire. So this potentiometer contains total 6 meter long wire. Okay, now you can see there are two cells connected with the same point A with a K. Okay, and there is a galvanometer connected with the help of a jockey. This one is jockey. Okay, so now suppose point 1 means cell 1 is working, it means this part is open. So this circuit is not working, means E2 is not working and E1 is working by this galvanometer. So if you touch the jockey at some point on this wire and you will get the null point, it means the potential of difference from A to that point is equal to the EMF of cell E1. Okay, because in this condition there is no current drawn from the cell and that is known as the EMF of the cell. So similarly, when cell 1 is open and 2 is closed and you can touch the jockey on the different points of the wire of this potentiometer, then at some point there is no current flowing through this galvanometer and that the potential difference between point A and that point, suppose N2, is equal to the EMF of this cell E2. Okay, so it means you can find out the EMF of this E1 and this E2 in terms of length of the wire of the potentiometer. Okay, because potential difference per unit length of this potentiometer is always constant. This is the basic principle of the potentiometer actually. So let's understand from the statement written here. Figure 3.28 shows an application of the potentiometer to compare the EMF of two cells E1 and E2. The point marked 1, 2, 3 form a two-way key. Okay, this one is a key. If one is closed, then two is open. It means only E1 is working and E2 is not working. Consider first position of the key 1 and 3 are connected. So this 1 and the 3 are connected. It means this galvanometer is working and this cell E1 is working. So that the galvanometer is connected to E1. The jockey is moved along the wire till at a point N1 at a distance L1 from A, there is no deflection in galvanometer. Okay, we can apply Kirchhoff's loop rule to the closed loop. So you can apply Kirchhoff's closed loop rule or you can directly write according to the law, that is if I is 0 then the potential difference is equal to the EMF of the cell. So if you want to apply the Kirchhoff's law in this closed loop, okay, you can apply. So in this EMF is E1, then current is I, so in this part potential difference is phi L1. So you can write phi L1 plus 0 minus E1 is equal to 0. This one is the first equation. Similarly, Now suppose this one is open and the two and three are closed. So now this one is closed. This two is closed and one is open. So this is not working. In this case, E2 is working and 3 is connected to E2. So galvanometer is working. And in the same process, you can touch this jockey on the different points of the wire of the potentiometer. And suppose at some point N2, this is the point, you will get the null point. It means there is no deflection in this galvanometer. Then suppose the length of this point N2 from A is L2. Okay, from A this length is L2. So in that case you can apply the Kirchhoff's loop rule again and you will get this value, that is phi L2 plus 0 minus E2. Or you can directly write, because there is no current in this galvanometer, in this case the potential difference between point A and N2 is equal to the EMF of the cell E2. Okay, so since you know that phi is the, this phi is potential drop per unit length, it means the potential of length L1 is phi L1, and similarly the potential of the length L2 is phi L2, and these potential differences are equal to the EMF of the cells. So you can directly write, either you can write these equations or you can directly write, you can directly write E1 is equal to phi L1 and E2 is equal to phi L2. Okay, since phi is constant, because phi is related to this battery, this battery has constant potential difference and current flowing in these wires. Okay, so the phi, it means potential drop per unit length in these wires due to this cell is same. So phi is same for both the cell. After dividing this equation number 3.90 by 3.91, if you divide these two equations, these phi will cancel out and you will get the equation 3.92, that is E1 by E2 is equal to L1 by L2. Okay, so this one is the method by which you can compare EMF of two primary cells. Okay, so by this method, you, by only measuring the length of the null point on the potentiometer wire, you can find out the EMF comparison of EMF of the two cells. Okay, so I hope you understand how you can find out the EMF of two cells. Now if this ratio is greater than 1, it means EMF of first cell is greater as compared to second one, and if this ratio is less than 1, it means EMF of the second cell is greater than the first one cell. Okay, so I hope you understand the concept how you can compare the EMF of the two cells by using potentiometer. Okay, so let's understand the second application, that is to find the internal resistance of this cell. So the circuit arrangement for finding the internal resistance of a given cell is shown in this figure. Okay, you can see here, this is the cell which is connected with the resistance box and a K2, this is K, Now this is connected to a galvanometer with a jockey. So in this, again, first we will open this circuit. Means when K2 is open, this K2 is open, it means there is no use of this resistance box. Okay, now, but this cell is working according to this circuit. This part of the circuit is no use. Now this part of circuit is working. Okay, let phi be the potential gradient, means potential per unit length of the wire is same, that is phi. Now if this cell is working in absence of this resistance box, the circuit will complete when this galvanometer shows reading after touching the wire of the potentiometer with the help of jockey. So let N2 be the point and N1 be another point. So let's understand, we can also use the potentiometer to measure internal resistance of the cell. For the cell EMF E, whose internal resistance is small r, is to be determined, is connected across resistance box through a K2 as shown in the figure. With K2 is open, balance obtained and length L1, suppose AN1 is equal to L1. So in this case, suppose this resistance box is not working and at point N1 there is the null point. It means the potential difference between point A and N is equal to E, means EMF of the cell, because there is no current flowing through the circuit. It means there is no current draw from this cell. Okay, so in that case E is equal to phi L1, because phi is potential gradient, that is constant, and L1 is the length of the potentiometer wire. So total potential difference from point A to N1 is phi L1. Okay, now suppose K2 is open. Suppose K2 is closed. When K2 is closed, then this circuit is closed. Okay, now there is some current drawn from the cell. In that case, this circuit is also closed. So if we touch the jockey at different points of the potentiometer wire, we get the null point, means there is no deflection through this cell at point N2. Okay, but in this case the potential difference between A and N2 is not the EMF, because there is current flowing in this circuit, in this closed circuit. You can see A, E, then resistance box K2, A. In this part of the circuit there is current flowing in this circuit. It means there is current drawn from this cell. So in this case the potential difference between point A and N2 is equal to the potential difference, or you can say terminal potential difference, but it is not equal to the EMF. But this potential difference can be written as V is equal to phi L2, since phi is constant for the potentiometer and L2 is the new balancing length. So you get EMF and you have terminal potential difference. Now you can take out some resistance R from this box, so that will be the external resistance. Okay, so if you have value of EMF, then external potential difference, and then external resistance, then I hope you remember a formula to find out the internal resistance of the cell, and that was given by R is equal to capital R in bracket E upon V minus 1. Okay, so this was the formula we have derived. Okay, So small r is equal to capital R E upon V minus 1. Now you can put the value of E, the value of V, then you will get L1 by L2 minus 1. By using that formula, you can see here R is equal to capital R L1 by L2 minus 1. You can find out the internal resistance of the cell. So student, I hope you understand this topic and try to solve this question. We will discuss in next class. Okay. Thank you for watching.